to KHC Singles Devotional for the 22nd of July 2021. The topic is My Thought-Provoking Letter to My Melancholy Husband, Part 1. I appreciate your quiet and peaceful nature. You love having your space and you cherish serenity a lot. You are never in a rush and you always take your time. You painstakingly face your career and you can stay behind your desk for hours without bulging. Your brain is one of a kind and I am still amazed after so many years about your intellectual capacity. You are so vast and brilliant. However, your passion for your work and your withdrawn posture is beginning to take toll on me and I feel I need to communicate with you through this medium. Dear, you know you could be so focused that I often feel neglected. Once you bury yourself inside those books and studies, you are near and yet very far to reach. Sometimes in your bid to finish what you started, you go to the extreme and stretch yourself unnecessarily. You know how to connect emotionally, but I would rather you balance it with a little of masculine toughness. You process things in your mind and this makes you a great listener. But most times you only reply my many words with a few sentences and responses that I am wondering whether you heard all I said. And dear, you set some goals and I am really wondering. Some of your goals are way beyond reach and I often wonder how you got them. Dear, you can be very boring, wink and pessimistic. You hurt so easily and that I am often scared and cautious before discussing with you. I am often scared about what next I would say that might hurt you. In fact, you seem to enjoy being hurt and pleasure yourself in it. You need to learn to forgive quickly, dear. Our lives will be more romantic if you can let go of those hurts. Dear, you have to learn how to resist the temptation to revenge all the time. I am your wife. Confession for the day. I declare that I have a spirit-filled temperament. My weaknesses will not limit me. I exchange my weaknesses for his strength. Prayers for the day. Lord, I ask for your grace that is sufficient for me. I ask that you open my eyes more to be able to maximize my strength and minimize my weaknesses in Jesus' name. Thoughts for the day. 1 Corinthians 15 verse 50 Message Translation. I need to emphasize, friends, that natural earthly lives don't in themselves lead us by their very nature into the kingdom of God. Their very nature is to die. So how could they naturally end up in the life kingdom? Action plan for the day. Identify bad habits and eliminate them. Create a routine of good habits.